Hi kids, it's Mark the Mechanic. Welcome to Celebration Online. Listen, do me a favor, like us, share, subscribe so you never miss an episode. We have a wonderful episode here today. Enjoy this episode.
Victory. Celebration, I'm Natalie, and we have been enjoying teaching you about the Father's love, about God's love for you. We know that He loves you so much that He sent Jesus to die for you, to rise again, and God wants all of us to be a part of His family. Well, today we're talking about how God is the Father to the fatherless. I have a question for you, Celebration. Have you ever lost something that's really important to you? For example, for me, I know that if I lose my wallet or my keys, I will tell my whole family to stop what they're doing and help me find it, because I can't buy anything without my wallet and I can't go anywhere without my keys. And so we stop everything until we find it. Or maybe for you, maybe you can't find that controller to your video game station, or maybe the remote control is lost and you can't watch anything. I know for us, we've turned up couch cushions and looked all around till we find the remote control. Well, Jesus told a story in the Bible about the parable of the lost sheep. And it's just like this with how much God loves you and wants everyone to be a part of His family. You see, Jesus told a story in Matthew 18. And He said, if there's a shepherd who has 100 sheep and just one of those sheep goes astray and wanders off, won't that shepherd leave the 99 and go find the one sheep? And when he finds that one sheep, won't he rejoice and clean up the sheep, heal its cuts? He'd rejoice more over finding that one than the 99 that stayed put. And the Bible tells us in our memory verse, Matthew 18:14, it says, even so, it is not the will of your Father which is in heaven that one of these little ones should perish. Matthew 18:14. Celebration, God doesn't want anyone to perish. He wants everyone to spend eternity in heaven with Him. He wants to be your Father and my Father. He loves you so much. Well, we want to encourage you to watch all the way to the end of today's episode for another secret code.
Well, hi, kids. My name is Mark the Mechanic. I love what I do. I'm a mechanic that works on cars, boats, anything that flies, drives, or rides. I work on it. I love it. Listen, speaking of love, I know somebody that loves you just as much as I hear an engine roar. And I do love to hear an engine roar. And it's called, his name is Jesus Christ. He's our Father God. Speaking of that, I'm thinking about a joke. Anybody want to hear a mechanic joke? Sure you do. What do you call a car with no wheels? Unwheel. That's funny, I tell you. Listen, my little mechanic technicians, God loves you so much. He loves you that He so much that He gave His only son Jesus, to live, to die, to raise again, just for you and me. God loves you. His love is just so amazing. Did you know that when you ask Jesus to be your Lord, to be the Lord of your life, you're receiving an amazing gift of salvation, that you're a child of God? Yep, you heard it. You are a child of God. You can look forward to all His benefits. He's your Father God. I mean, His benefits like healing, prosperity, forgiveness for your sins. Sometimes our dads are real busy, you know, and sometimes they get tired. But Jesus never gets tired. God never gets tired. He's always there for us. God will be your Father. Kids, did you know during the winter, mechanics like me, we find all kinds of stuff underneath the hood of cars. You know, things that's just trying to be warm, trying to find a warm place to stay. You know, similar to this cat. He was found in the hood of this car in the wintertime. You know, someone left him someone left them. So what happens is, you know, similar to him, oh, he's getting back to his regular place here. So what happens is, people leave him. You know, he's not like God. God never leaves us. God never leaves us. Pastor Steve had a similar cat to that one. Someone left beside the road. God wouldn't do that. God is here for us. He maintains everything he says. He is here for us. His love never changes. God's love never changes. Matthew 18:14 says, even though it's not the will of the Father, which is in heaven, that one of these little ones should perish. Yep, you heard it right. God wants all with him. All, just like you, kids, all of you with him. So I gotta go, but you know I got another joke. You ready to hear it? I love my jokes. What kind of car does a cat have? A Ferrari. That's great. I love it. See you later, kids.
Hello, kids. Today's Bible story is found in Matthew chapter 18, verses 1 through 14. Now, that's a lot of verses, but go read it.
God's story, one lost sheep. So part of God's story is about a shepherd and a lost sheep, and it goes like this. Jesus spent a lot of time teaching people about God's love. And sometimes, people wanted to spend time with Jesus after he got finished teaching. So they would invite him over for dinner. Jesus loved to spend time with people. Jesus would even hang out with people who no one else wanted to hang out with. This bothered some other people, called Pharisees. Pharisees were religious experts who thought it was wrong for Jesus to spend time with certain kinds of people. One day, the Pharisees muttered, "Jesus welcomes sinners and eats with them." But Jesus knew God still loves people, even when we make wrong choices. So Jesus told the Pharisees a story to teach them a lesson about God. These stories were called parables. This is the parable of the one lost sheep. Jesus said, "Suppose you were a shepherd with 100 sheep, and one of your sheep got lost. Wouldn't you leave the 99 in open country and go after the sheep until you found it? And when you found it, you would joyfully put the sheep on your shoulders and take it home. And when you got home, you would call your friends and neighbors together and say, 'Rejoice with me! I have found my lost sheep!'" The people listening were probably thinking about the shepherds they knew. Good shepherds paid attention to their sheep. They knew each one by name, and they kept them safe from danger. They would have remembered the poems by the prophet Ezekiel and King David, where God said he was like a shepherd. Of course, a good shepherd would want all of his sheep to be safe, and would do whatever it took to rescue his one lost sheep, even risking his own life. Then Jesus explained the parable to the Pharisees. "In the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who do not need to repent." See, the 99 sheep are like people who already believe in Jesus. The lost sheep are like the people who don't know how much God loves them or that Jesus came to rescue them. And Jesus is the good shepherd who was willing to lay down his own life to rescue his lost sheep. Jesus said that he came to seek and save those who are lost. When a person starts to follow Jesus said it's like a party in heaven. We don't really know exactly what a party in heaven looks like. But since God made everything, and God is the reason good things like love and fun and laughter exist, a party in heaven is probably bigger and better than anything we could imagine. And Jesus wants everyone to know that it's a party where everyone is invited. Because every single person matters to God. And that's the story of the shepherd and one lost sheep. So in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Jesus told stories called parables. One parable is about a shepherd and 100 sheep. One sheep got lost. The shepherd left the 99. The lost sheep was found. The shepherd threw a party because God cares about every single person. And that's a part of God's story.
kids, we had so much fun today teaching you about God's love. God loves you. Well, I wanted you to meet my little kitty, Bentley. He's just a kitten. He's about 8 months old, and he was abandoned. He had no mother, no father. He was just left on the side of the road. So my family adopted him, and he became part of our family. We love him, we take care of him, we feed him, and we protect him from the dogs. Well, kids, that's what God wants for you. He wants you to become part of his family. And the way you become part of God's family is to pray the prayer of salvation and become born again. So if you have never done that, I would like to invite you to pray with me today. Say this prayer with me. Father God, I thank you for Jesus. I believe that you sent Jesus to this earth to live, to die, and to rise again just for me. I confess Jesus as my Lord and my Savior. Father, I am sorry for all the wrong things I have done, all the sin I have committed, and I ask you to forgive me and to wash me clean. I accept Jesus as my Lord and Savior, my King of Kings, my Lord of Lords. Father, I thank you for saving me. I thank you for giving me Jesus and providing me a way for eternity. Father, I love you. I praise you. I thank you for Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, kids, if you said that prayer, you are now part of God's family. You have been adopted into God's family. You are now a Christian. Best decision ever. Well, we love you. I'm so glad you watched Celebration Online today. Until next time, bye. Bentley Town, bye. Bye, everybody.
Today's secret code is God is a father to the fatherless.
Thank you for watching Celebration Online. Kids, I want to encourage you to make sure that you're in church. At every one of our Family Worship Center locations, we have an amazing children's ministry that you can be a part of. If you live here in Florence, come see us. You can meet my husband, Pastor Steve, and see myself over here in Celebration. If you live in Columbia, please connect with Pastor JT and Miss Natalie at their church. And if you live in Georgetown, please go see Pastor Justin and Miss Joanna at their church. And finally, if you live in the Sumter area, we invite you to connect with Family Worship Center Sumter online. You can visit fwcsumter.com to be a part of our online community as we begin building Family Worship Center's newest location. Kids, come see us in Celebration at Family Worship Center. We have a great time every Sunday.